mitochondria is the main source of metabolism in the muscles. What your mitochondria do is they take the fuels that you eat and then they convert the energy from the fuel, whether it's fat or carbohydrates, they convert that energy into the type of energy that you need to fuel your muscle contraction. Don't have mitochondria, you don't have movement. I'm Brian Glancy, investigator from the Muscle Energetics Laboratory. Muscle energetics is how your muscle uses energy in order to be able to move. My whole life I've been interested in both sports, but I've also been interested in math and science. And so when I was trying to think of, okay, what type of career do I want to do? Studying muscle metabolism, energy metabolism, became a natural fit for me. In muscle cells, there's a lot of mitochondria on the edge of the cell. Big amounts of mitochondria, they're not near the contractile parts of the muscle fiber. And so the question was, how does the energy that those mitochondria produce, how does it get actually to the contractile proteins that are gonna contract and actually make your muscles move? So what most scientists thought was that energy moved throughout muscle cells primarily according to diffusion or facilitated diffusion, which is similar to if you drop some ink into a glass of water and the way you see it slowly spread throughout the glass of water. And so we thought maybe that they're connected in some type of way. We started to look at the muscle fiber in three dimensions with really high resolution images. And what we found was that these big pools of mitochondria along the edge of the cell, they actually had little processes, little wires coming out of them that went deep into the middle of the muscle fiber to the parts of the muscle where the contractile proteins are actually connected to the mitochondria on the inside of the cell where you actually need to send the energy to fuel muscle contraction. Eventually we found a method that we could change the electrical voltage in the middle of the cell and to see what would happen in the areas outside that area. So the theory would be that if they were all electrically connected, if we change the voltage in the middle, then we should see a change on the mitochondria on the outside of the cell. What happened was when we lowered the voltage in the middle of the cell, the voltage lowered everywhere and all the mitochondria surrounding it. And so that was our evidence that the mitochondrial network was all connected electrically. There's a lot of different things that this opens up. One is to start looking at other types of cells, like the heart, for example, to see if there are electrically coupled mitochondrial networks there. The other thing that it does is it can provide potentially new targets for people that have mitochondrial diseases or they have some kind of low functioning mitochondria. So really what it does is it gives us a whole bunch of new things to go after to try to find targets to help people.